Hello and welcome to this video talking about power amplifier measurement with digital pre-distortion DPD using Keysight's test software called PathWave X-series measurement applications. If you are not familiar with DPD theory, please go to the link in the description box at first. There's a video talking about this part. In this video, I will demonstrate how to do PA test with DPD by using N9055EM0E X-app PA application running on Keysight VXT PXIe Transceiver. This VXT PXIe Transceiver integrates VXT and VSA in a PXIe module. As we can see, it does not need LAN connection between SA and SG. It uses internal trigger and the reference as the default. It is easy for you to set up the tester environment. Okay, now let's look at the demo. X-app supports user-defined waveform format in power amplifier measurement as well. Next, let's take a look at a demo of PA measurement with user-defined Wi-Fi 6 signal. Set source frequency to 2.412 GHz and set up measurement standard to predefined wireless LAN A02.11AX 160 MHz. Press OK. And then set reference signal. This time we choose user-defined waveform and choose filter type to CSV. Quickly filter out all Excel file formats, then select the test signal we need and set sample rate to 480 MHz. Next, config analyzer's frequency at 2.412 GHz. Modify power amplifier gain output power. Enable power servo to set power level of test which we did before. Because this is a burst signal, we need to set our DPD measurement time to active length. Here is 868 microseconds. The PA measurement will automatically start. Before to test the PA, let's go into wireless LAN modulation analysis measurement. After set up radio standard to A02.11AX, we can see the measurement is passed. The constellation diagram is clean and EVM is good here. Then we go back to the power amplifier measurement. Actually, the setup we have in wireless LAN mode can be coupled in PA mode. So once you coupled the setting, you can make the same EVM measurement inside the PA mode. As we set PA output is minus 10 dBm, it is in the linear region as shown in AM-AM graph. ACP looks pretty clean. Now we increase the PA output power to 7 dBm. We can see the spectral regrowth in adjacent channels decrease ACPR dynamic range. In AM-AM graph, enable normalized setting. Use auto scale button to help better view. We can see PA is in nonlinear region now. Then we select DPD memory polynomial method and enable DPD. ACPR and EVM are both improved here. PA is closer in linear region now. Dynamic EVM is similar to a standard EVM measurement for power amplifier. It's usually for burst signal with the assumption that the DC power to the PA is turned on shortly before the beginning of the burst and then turned off shortly after the end of the burst. The key to the measurement is to understand the impact on the EVM when the DC power of the PA is turned on and off. N9055EM0E X-app PA measurement application provides setup and control as shown in this timing diagram. The T1, T3, T4 are required to be set, and then PA enable mask is built and routed to mark 2 source of the instrument, which will be used to control PA power on and off. The actual EVM measurement is just in T2 duration, which is same as standard EVM measurement. So in X-app, for the Wi-Fi 6 burst signal, let's enable burst shape and mask setting to configure this timing information and do the standard EVM measurement in T2 duration. In summary, the X-app provides a comprehensive set of tools for demodulation and signal analysis. These tools enable you to measure and troubleshoot power amplifier in different scenarios with confidence. To learn more and to download a free trial, visit us at this website.